I always get my best cocktail ideas when I'm eating, which, if you've been following along with this channel, you must have guessed that by now. If you haven't been following along, please hit the subscribe button and the bell icon. It would really help me grow my channel, and then you'll never miss an original cocktail recipe, which usually comes with how-tos for your own liqueurs, bitters, and shrubs. And speaking of shrubs, let's dive into today's video. Today's video is another entry into a theme I've been continuing of taking foods and reimagining them as cocktails. I've done this with banoffee pie, key lime pie, tzatziki sauce, baguette with butter and jam, and now the caprese salad. Well, I guess it's more of a springtime version since it's not yet tomato season, and I'll be using gooseberries. This is my version of a springtime caprese salad, if it were a cocktail. I like to use these Cape gooseberries, or golden berries as they're also known. They're a relative of the tomato, but more closely related to a tomatillo. They have an amazing sweet and tart flavor that's a mix between sweet and savory. They kind of taste like a cherry tomato mixed with mango. I'm going to use them to make a zesty gooseberry shrub. To balance out the shrub's tartness, I'll be utilizing burrata water, or whey, which will provide creaminess and a bit of salinity. For the basil aspect, I will be making a basil-flavored lace tuile as garnish. I'll also give the glass a spray of absinthe to mimic the anise notes from basil. The whole cocktail will be rounded out with London dry gin. To make the shrub, I'm going to hull a pint of Cape gooseberries. Then I'll cut them into quarters to provide more surface area for maceration. Once I've hulled and quartered the gooseberries, I'll transfer them into a wide and shallow container and then weigh them. Now I'll just cover them with 3/4 the amount of sugar by weight. I don't use a 1-to-1 ratio on gooseberries because they don't macerate as well as other fruits because the skin is not very porous. I like to stir them a bit with sugar to make sure they're all coated well, then just let them sit in the fridge for a day or two until all or most of the sugar has dissolved. Once the syrup has formed, I'll strain off the gooseberry solids and funnel into a jar. The residual gooseberries make an excellent jam. 1 pint of macerated gooseberries yielded 1/2 cup of syrup. To the syrup, I'm adding 1/3 cup of apple cider vinegar, give it a shake to combine, and then the shrub is ready to go. For a faster version, you can add the sugar and quartered gooseberries straight into a pot and heat until the sugar has dissolved. Then, once it's cooled, add the vinegar. I really like tart shrubs, but if it's a bit too tart, it will mellow in the fridge the longer you let it sit. Even after just a day, the acid should subside. To incorporate the basil element, I'm going to make a basil tuile for the garnish. First, I'm going to pick a few leaves of basil. I'm using about 10 leaves. To keep the color of the garnish green, I'm going to blanch the basil by pouring boiling water over the leaves. Once they turn bright green, I will submerge them into an ice bath to preserve the color. Now I will add 3 ounces of water to the basil and blend using my immersion blender. Then I'll strain it to remove any large particles. To my basil water, I'm going to add 1 tablespoon of flour and whisk until there are no more clumps. Now comes the messy part. I'm going to heat a pan over medium heat, then add some canola oil. Once the oil is hot, I'm going to pour in about 1/3 of the batter and cover with a splatter screen, because there's going to be hot oil splattering like crazy, so be careful if you're attempting to make this at home. Once it's only mildly sizzling and the color has darkened, it's ready to remove from the pan. I wasn't too happy with the color on the tuile, so I added a few drops of green food coloring to the batter and made another. The color was much better on this one. I let it cool on a paper towel and lightly blot it to remove the residual oil. For the burrata part of this drink, I'm going to be utilizing the leftover whey from a burrata container. Whey adds a nice creamy texture to cocktails, and it can also add some foam too, thanks to a bit of protein from the whey. I'm just going to pour off the whey into my nifty milk carton, so it's easier to pour when building the drink. Before I start building the cocktail, I'm going to spritz my coupe a few times with absinthe to mimic the anise flavors from the basil. To build the cocktail, I'll first add 1 ounce of the gooseberry shrub to my shaker tin. Next, I'll add 1/2 ounce of whey. And lastly, I'll add 1.5 ounces of Ford's gin. I'll add the ice and give this a good 10-second shake. Then I'll strain it into my absinthe rinsed glass. Lastly, I will rest the basil tuile garnish on top. This one was really tasty. I really like how the whey, gin, and absinthe coalesce together. And the shrub adds a nice sharpness that cuts through the creaminess of the whey. Does it taste like a caprese salad? It could definitely taste more like one, so I think I'll try it again with a more neutral spirit like a cucumber-infused vodka, as the gin was a bit overpowering. All in all, I think it was a really fun experiment, and I look forward to trying it again once tomatoes are in season. I hope you've enjoyed this If It Were a Cocktail episode. Please let me know what other desserts or dishes you'd love to see turned into a cocktail. I do love a good challenge, so go wild. As always, thank you, thank you, thank you for tuning in and subscribing. We just reached 400 subscribers, and I want to thank everyone that tunes in every week to support this channel. It means so much to us. I'll see you again next week with another cocktail video. Cheers and have a great week.